talking about the hireling when and then they killed his son. You know what I'm saying? It might be in Matthew or Mark. But keep reading.
I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
This is Isaki. He says, and whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are a rebellious house, yet shall know that there had been a prophet among them.
Yeah, so you're going to know it's been a prophet among you. It ain't going to be no, well, if you would have sent me somebody, Lord, if you would have warned me, if you would have told me, get Ezekiel 3 and 18.
To warn the wicked from the wicked way to save his life.
Yeah. So, you know, we out here telling you, you know what I'm saying, look, if you don't do right, you're going to, well, see, because basically we the mouthpiece of the Lord right now. Surely the Lord will do nothing but he reveal his secrets to his servants, the prophets. So if we know the Lord's intentions and we got an understanding of this book, then we responsible to bring it out. So that's why the Lord said, if you fail to warn the wicked that he shall surely die, what's gonna happen? You know what I'm saying? Keep reading.
To save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity. But his blood will I require at thy hand.
Yeah, because you know what? Because he gonna die in his iniquity because, you know, he angered the Most High, he moved the Lord to wrath. But his blood gonna be quite at your hands because you refuse to let him know. You know what I'm saying? You refuse to let him know. Danger, look, the Lord on your ass, be cool, you know. Just follow the law, statute, commandments.
I've got that too.
Matthew 21.
About the supper.
About the son.
Don't get it. It kind of bad.
Okay, yeah. Good. We drop it.
You got a precept. Get your precept and then go back to that.
This the book of James.
I mean, I don't know if this was you was going.
Go ahead. You just bring it out.
Book of James, chapter 1, verse 22. But be ye doers of the word, not hearers only, deceiving your own selves.
Yep.
For if any man be a hearer of the word, not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his whole natural face in a glass.
Yeah, because you know what? Understanding the truth, we like in the Holy Scriptures, we call it the truth. So when we say the truth, that's what we're talking about, the correct understanding of the Bible. That requires action. That's why the Scripture said, be doers of the word instead of hearers, because it requires action. You know what I'm saying? So go back to that Ezekiel.
Require at thy hand.
Yeah.
Verse 19. Yet if thou warn the wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way.
Because that's what we doing. We out here warning the wicked that if you don't get right and follow the Lord, the people on this sign, which make up the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, it's a terrible judgment for your ass. The Lord got something for your ass. It's all time out for that play shit. All that, my grandma been saying the world gonna end for 20, 30 years. Y'all been saying that shit. Y'all been out here, look. We out here for a sign, and we a sign, and we holding signs. The Lord ain't finna come to you directly and fucking tell you and tap you on the back of the shoulder and tell you, look, man, I'ma kill your ass if you don't follow me. He telling you that through us. That's why the scripture just said, if thou warn the wicked, read that part over again.
Boogie is 19.
Yeah, 19.
Boogie Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 19. Yet if thou warn the wicked, and he turned not from his wickedness.
So if he don't give a damn what the Bible got to say, if he want to keep living his life smoking weed, popping other people's woman, you know what I'm saying? Instead of getting his own goddamn woman, it's a million out here. Right. You want to fuck another dude woman, you know, sell crack, drugs, be a faggot. If we telling you, your ass going off, you wrong, and you ignore us and you disregard us, what it say?
Turn not from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity. But thou hast delivered thy soul.
So he gonna die in his iniquity. Iniquity means sin. So the sins you committed, oh, you gonna pay for them, but it ain't got shit to do with, it ain't got shit to do with us. Cause we told you was going off. Cause a lot of our people, they do wrong and wickedness and they don't even know it. You know what I'm saying? Like, people don't know it's wrong to eat pork. The Lord told you in Leviticus, the 11th chapter, that the swine, don't touch it. Don't touch his carcass, it's an abomination to you.
Just to show you, Jay just want to do right. What if Philip said it to the eunuch? He said, understand with thy readers. Mm-hmm. He said, how can I, for man teach me, you know?
Yeah.
He said, he wanted to do right, but he couldn't understand. So that's what Philip started to sub with, you know? Said, you know, man, you got some Jakes out there, I really want to do right. Mm-hmm. I just don't know how to do right. You know, that's when you have to, you know, really ask and sincerely for the Lord, you know? That's when you got to drop your Bible and say, hey, Lord, I want your name.
Yep.
You know? So, hey, the Lord give it to you, man. You know, the Lord, that's because you sincerely want it, man. You want it wholeheartedly. But if you really want this thing, if you just put it in your back pocket, like, you know, hey, I read it when I can, you know?
That's taking it for granted because
exactly. That's
what they do. You know what I'm saying? Because
yep.
they done heard all their life, you know, hey, we in the last days. We in the last days. So now they done turned that into something cliche-like. You know what I'm saying? But it's not cliche, man. You know? Look, what's going on, man. You can get on YouTube and you see all these different Israelite camps out here. All these Israelites waking up, man, worldwide, man, global.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And prophesying, man, especially GMS, Great Millstone, out of the scriptures, man, and bring the scriptures to life, man. That should tell you something right there, man. And then look, not only that, man, look, the signs of the times, man. Look at the signs of the times. Look, you don't even know the seasons. From one from another, man.
It's
like
February.
The Lord said, man. I seen bees again yesterday, bro.
Yeah, bro.
I ain't seen bees in so long, bro.
I seen a wasp.
If I see a bee, I might catch one of them motherfuckers, bro.
Some bumblebees, right in February. What'd that tell you, man?
It's winter, bro.
It's winter, bro.
It's winter weather, bro.
And they was literally flying around and shit, man. I'm like, damn. Man, we in those days, man.
Hey, women
man.
Already starting to show their toes. They putting on sandals and shit.
Yeah.
Wearing shorts and all. Man, it's crazy. It's only February.
It's the middle of February.
Hey, that's what the Lord said, man. He said that these are the signs of the times. This is when you're going to know, man. And then there's already earthquakes happening all over the place,
In diverse places, man.
These things are happening right now, man. And there's rumors and rumors of war. You know, the beginning of World War III has already taken place. What else you got going on right now, man? If you paying attention to the news, man, there's a lot of shit going on with the EU.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know, hey, man, prophecy is being unfolded, man, right before you, man. You know what I'm saying? They're about to get ready to dump this bitch America and turn on her, man.
Yeah.
That's prophecy, man.
Got a precept.
Dump this bitch. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, you got to pay attention, man.
I got a precept.
Let's see Jake out here, you know what I'm saying, walking around all docile, not paying attention, man. Hey, man, that's when sudden destruction going to come for you, man. You know what I'm saying? Because you're not paying attention. You don't know, man. You know what I'm saying? That's when that cliche going to suddenly, you know, become reality, man. It's going to be a reality for your ass, man. And it's going to be too late. It's going to be too late, man.
I had a question.
Hold on, you got a question? Okay.
So what's this about Jesus having... That's not... I don't believe that's... That like, y'all believe that's his name? Like, Jesus?
Yeah.
No.
when did the letter J didn't come around to the 1600s?
That's what I figured.
I was gonna say, so my question is, if a person is saying his name, what was his name before the 1600s?
And then you gotta understand too, proper names don't translate. So Jesus actually come from the word Iesus, and it's Greek. But we know that whom they called Jesus when he walked on this earth, he wasn't a Greek. He was a Hebrew Israelite. He was an Israelite from the tribe of Judah that spoke Hebrew. So if I'm a Hebrew Israelite from the tribe of Judah and I speak Hebrew, and my parents are the same, and my parents named me, then I got a Hebrew name. You know what I'm saying? You can't, like, even if you ever watching the Spanish channel, and they mention another country, you watching the Spanish news, and they say, Donald Trump, America, because those are proper names. You can't translate a proper name.
Right.
You know?
That's when a person says, if you know a person says a different language, how you say my name proper, in that language? You say your name's gonna be the same. He's probably gonna have an accent too. You know, if you speak Russian, your name should be Trevian. You know, it's gonna be that name, but just with a different accent.
Get Malachi 1:14.
You get Malachi 1:14.
Unless you got something. And you know why? First of all, they took the Lord's name out of the Bible because it's power. You know what I'm saying? If you ever look into something that got to do with frequency, vibration, and sounds, that's power. Like, you know what I'm saying? It affects your body. You know what I'm saying? It affects you. Like, with all this nigga music, all this rapping and shit, these niggas listening to that shit and going to kill shit. You ain't ever listening to a song and like, damn, this song make me feel like smoking. This song make me feel like going to do some wicked evil shit, because you know, sound holds sound and frequency and vibration, it affects you. You know what I'm saying? And that's the ultimate, the highest, you know what I'm saying? That's our power. If Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, which is the correct name of the Father and the Son, if we call on him and if we call on him to come save us out of our affliction, he'll come deliver us.
All at once.
The heathen nations know that. So they like, wait a minute, we gotta cut them off from everything that they know, because the Bible is our heritage. Like before we was like doing the slavery.
Yeah, let me read that for
go
you.
Ahead.
I'll
go ahead.
Back that up real quick. This is Malachi 1:14.
Mm-hmm.
It says, but curse.
Hold on, Salakia, can somebody get, I want the proverb first. The 30:4, what is the son name? What is,
Malachi 1.
Yeah.
You hold that, okay, come.
Yeah.
This is Proverbs 30:4.
Yeah.
It says, who had ascended up into heaven or descended?
See, it's actually a question saying who went up to heaven or who came back down from heaven, all right?
Mm-hmm. Who, it's like, yeah, who had gathered the winds in his fist? Who had bound the waters in his garments? Who had established all the ends of the earth?
Now we know it's a rhetorical question, because we know who've done it. Whom the world ignorantly calls God, you know, he done it. But keep reading, let's see what the scriptures say.
He says, who have established the ends, Slakia, all the ends of the earth? What is his name?
What is his name? And what else?
And what is his son's name?
Just to show you, it's not two same persons.
See, they separate. See, some people teach that they're one and the same, but they're two separate entities.
Trinity.
Oh, you got God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Yeah. What that means is that they're all in agreement. Now, let's say you on the Chicago Bulls team, right? You the point guard, you the shooting guard, and I'm the center. But we all Chicago Bulls, but we all separate entities.
Once you think of that, man, the first thing that should come to your mind, the world got a saying, there's no I in team. Mm-hmm. So that's how basically you should think of the Father and the Son, man. They're mm-hmm. one, when they say they're one, they're basically on one accord.
They're on one accord, they're in agreement.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. If me and this brother go inhabit that store and take it completely over, and we got a group called the Takeovers, they're not gonna say, Kaya and Gabaria took it over. No, they're gonna say, hey, the Takeovers took that over. You know, just to show you type of, for an example.
Finish that scripture.
Khan, he says, and what is his name? And what is his son's name, if thou canst tell?
So if you can tell. So that means a lot of people don't know the name. So it's like, what is the son's name? Or what is his name and what is his son's name, if thou can tell? You know what I'm saying? Because they like, God is not a name. God is a title. God basically just means a power. Like we gods. You know what I'm saying? The scripture says that. Get Psalm 80. Read Malachi 1:14 and get Psalm 82. The scriptures say we gods. You know, we just, God basically goes back to the Hebrew word Allah. Like even the people that believe in the Quran, the Muslim, Allah just mean power. That's not the name of God. You know what I'm saying? If you actually got into the Quran and actually read it, it actually says that God has many names, we just don't know them. But that directly contradicted what the Bible say. Because the Bible say his name is one. You know what I'm saying? When you get Exodus 3:16. But all right, get the song real quick. Get the song real quick.
16?
3:16.
So, 82:6. I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High.
See, it was said, you are gods, and all of you are the children of the Most High, because we are children of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? He our Father. He get Joel 2:27.
Yeah, keep reading it, though. Keep reading it. It's going on too.
But you shall die like men.
If I stand right now, I'm going to die just like an average person. Even though you're a God. Now, what is that? Now, today playing field, who was known for jumping? Who was the only man that was known for jumping from the half-court line and slam dunking the ball?
Yeah.
Who was known for that?
Michael
Jordan. Jake.
Yeah.
Who was known
the
for
Israelite.
Who was known for dominated UFC? There's only one man that when you think of UFC, come to, man. Anderson Silva, which is a Brazilian, which is an Israelite, man. Israelites are the only people that can dominate anything that they put their hand to, man. We are gods, but if I go to a gun and shoot that man, he gonna die like an average guy. But they're doing God-like things, man.
An average
person can't do that. If I try to do that, even though I'm Israelite, I might, you know, if I train to do it. But if an Edomite do it, ain't no Edomite gonna do that, man.
Yep.
And if you do see a so-called white person do that, that's how I see he probably an Israelite, man.
Yep.
You know, so that's what it's, you know, it says you shall die like men, saying that, you know, you're going to die like an average person.
Yeah, you know.
Just like it, Brian.
No, you good. Don't get Joel 2:27. Because it's pertinent to understand that, get Deuteronomy 4:6 real quick. It's pertinent to understand that these people on this sign got a power and nobody else in the world do. And when you... Who got Joel 2:27? Go ahead, read that real quick. And it ain't what we saying, it's what the book say. The book say this, you know what I'm saying? But that's why they try to keep us so far away from this. Matter of fact, Salakia, we ain't finished Malachi 1:14. Who got, get Malachi 1:14 real quick.
It's the book of Malachi chapter 1, verse 14.
Mm-hmm.
But cursed be the deceiver which hath in his flock a male or a bot. By you and sacrifice it unto the Lord a corrupt thing.
Mm-hmm.
For I am a great king, saith the Lord of hosts, and my name is dreadful amongst the heathen. Mm-hmm. Among the heathen.
You know what we just said? Your name Ashi, ain't it?
Yeah.
You heard what he just said? Read that again. The last part.
Okay.
I am a great
For
king.
I am a great king, saith the Lord of hosts.
So the Lord of hosts. He just said, he's speaking of himself. He said, I'm a great king. Keep reading.
And my name is dreadful among the heathen.
So his name is dreadful, means scary and terrifying. So he said his name is terrifying among the heathen. So if you're not on this sign, if your ancestry don't go back to nobody on this sign, you classify as a heathen.
That's right.
They've been teaching us all our life that we've been the Gentiles, when in actuality, we're the children of God. And that's what we out here telling people. We the children of God. Y'all stole, get oppressed a man in his hair. You know what I'm saying? Because read Joel 2:27. It's gonna come to it because God is for us. You know what I'm saying? When whom the world calls God, you know what I'm saying? The Most High. When Moses led the children of Israel out of Egypt, who was with him? Was it the children of Israel and the children of Ammon? I was just thinking Ammon too. Was it the children of Israel and Ammon? Was it the children of Israel and the Egyptians? It was the children of Israel. So the Lord revealed himself to the children of Israel alone.
And what did the Lord also reveal why Moses was with the children of Israel? The statutes, laws, and commandments. Why? Because they're the only people that's going to serve and follow those, because those are the only people that was given unto those, man. He didn't say, write these, and after you get done with the children of Israel, go give it to the Egyptians, or go give it to Moab, or go give it to the Israelites, the Hebrews, after you get done with these people. No, man, it was only for those sect of people.
Because the Lord ain't no happy-go-lucky nice guy. If you remember the story, he fucked them Egyptians over. He gave their ass 10 plagues, and then
rigorous plagues.
We gave them 9 first, and then that last final 10th plague destroyed the firstborn of everything Egyptian. Yep. The Lord systematically destroyed the Egyptian economy. When all their fields and crops and water was destroyed, then he destroyed their people by killing all the firstborn males, even other animals. And then when you go into the plagues, after the hail and the fire from the sky was smiting animals. So the Lord totally destroyed the Egyptians, and they never rose to preeminence again.